Hi, everyone. I'm just going to check again. Can everyone hear me? I'm also going to type in the chat just to see if a few people are having any trouble. Just give me a feedback if you can hear me on audio. Awesome. Some people can hear. Okay, great. And you guys can see the screen too? Perfect. Awesome, guys. Thank you for the feedback. So we're ready to start here. First of all, I'm trying to mute everyone just so we can make sure that we don't really have a feedback during the presentation on the audio. If you have any questions, just please make sure to put on the chat for me, and then we'll make sure to address those at the end as well. And in the presentation, so first of all, I'm going to start introducing myself. My name is Joanna Schlinkert. I am an assistant director for admissions and recruitment here at WP Carey. I work directly with the full-time MBA program. And
My name is Stephen Treadwell. I work with Joanna on the full-time MBA. I'm also an assistant director of admission and recruitment. And I guess let's go ahead and let's introduce
our ambassadors,
our current student ambassadors. So why don't you guys just go ahead and jump on in?
Great. I'm Jessica Baer. I'm a first-year MBA student. I am concentrating in business analytics and supply chain management, and really focusing on a special project on how to identify modern slavery and how to end it through the supply chain.
Yeah. Hi. I'm Shivashankar. I'm a second-year MBA student concentrating in marketing and business analytics. Along with Dave, who you can see here, the third person here. So we both are leading the product management club at ASU.
Hi, everyone. I'm Dave Lavecchio. I did my undergrad at Penn State. I come from a background in healthcare IT, and now I'm focusing on marketing while I'm here. In addition to what Shiva mentioned, I'm also involved in a few other things here. I'm the head baseball coach for the club team here at ASU, and involved in a few other things.
Awesome. Can you tell them who is Ashani?
Yeah, and so Ashani Sharma is actually in class for another few minutes, but Ashani and I are the co-directors for the ambassador program. So we kind of make sure that, you know, we're able to connect prospective students with our current ambassadors based on, you know, levels of interest and hobbies and things like that.
Awesome. Thank you, guys. Okay, so we're going to go today through some of the examples of type of club that we have, and then they can tell us about their experiences. So I think the first one we're going to start off is the ambassadors, which this is why they were invited also here for the webinar. And then we're going to go through the MBA Association, the academic clubs, and then we can explain what they are, what is the difference of the professional clubs, and then special interest clubs as well. And then in the end, we want to close with a little bit of the WP Carey culture. Okay, so it started off a little with the ambassadors. Could you guys describe me a little bit, what is the ambassadors and what they do? What do you do in this role? Who wants to go first?
So I can start. So really the purpose of us having ambassadors is to give some insights within the program as to, you know, what you can expect going through the process to apply to WP Carey, as well as when you're here, and really trying to alleviate any concerns, as well as answer any questions that, you know, prospective students may have as they're trying to decide where the best place for them, you know, to do their MBA is. So, you know, ambassadors here do a variety of different things related to when individuals are on campus for interviews, as well as additional events. And, you know, if you guys want to talk to a few of those things.
For me, I can speak from an international perspective. So I came to the US for the first time to do my MBA. So for me, it's all through the ambassadors. I could understand about the culture here, about the experience here, and what I can expect, and what are the criteria that I should be focusing on when I'm choosing my B school. So ambassador was really the connection point between me and the school to understand more of the school and get insights into what I can expect in the next 2 years.
For my perspective, I'm actually a career pivot. I used to own two different companies, interior design business, and then we also own a lot of multifamily housing complexes. And so I had a lot of questions about coming back to school and retailing. And actually, Ishani, she is my mentor. So we chatted a lot. We'd go to events together, and it just helped me have more confidence moving forward and just getting perspectives on day-to-day routines, who to talk to, and what was best to, like, even down to, like, what classes and groups to join.
Okay. Thank you. Do you have any question for them in terms of investors? I think I wanted to understand a little bit, if you have anyone incoming, why would you tell them, like, what is the one reason to be an investor?
Well, the first thing that comes to mind is it's easy, right? You're just giving your perspective from the experiences you've had. And really, when you're trying to decide where you want to school, where you want to go to school, you really want to get an organic perspective from individuals that are here. And so that's why I think a lot of people enjoy the ambassador program, is because, you know, it's an easy platform to help and to give back. And, you know, for people to just, you know, give you or ask you what your perspective is on the experiences you've had here.
Yeah, it's a great point, because, you know, you can always speak to somebody like Joanna or myself about the actual process, but to have that insight from, you know, current students, people who've gone through the program, gone through the process themselves as far as, you know, joining the MBA program or even coming from a different country for the first time out here, these are the people that you could really rely on to get a very good grasp of the atmosphere at a particular college. So I'm hoping to see a lot of questions in the chat by the end of this webinar, just so that we can get some of your questions answered, because you're not going to gain a better perspective than from these individuals themselves.
That is awesome. So thank you guys for working with us and doing this job. It's awesome. Okay, so going to the next type of clubs, there is an MBA association. Can anyone explain to me what it is?
So the MBA Association, for those of you potentially during your undergrad, you probably heard of something called student council or student government. I would say that's probably the easiest way to relate to what we call the MBA Association. So it's really that governing body of elected individuals within our classes who are tasked with, you know, putting the best interests of the collective class forward. So a lot of decisions are made through them. You know, we have different positions within that. You know, we have a co-president position, we have a VP of finance, we have a VP of innovation, we have a VP of alumni relations, and a few other roles. And really, so holistically, if you think about that, they're just trying to make sure that we continue to elevate the W.P. Carey experience while we're here. And they're really that voice between what all of us as students are saying and then working with our university leaders to make sure that we can be putting the best experience forward.
Awesome. Jessica, you're part of it, right? So can you tell me an example of what you have done with them so far, or an event?
MBA Association. One of the things I really admire about them is that they're open to feedback. There's lots of, like, town meetings, and so when you have, like, a legitimate concern, or if you have, like, a special project you'd like to assist in, people are really great at networking and rallying around you and giving you a really great sounding board to flesh out those ideas.
Awesome. Okay. Any other thing? And do you feel that with this one, is there any type of skill set that you can grow by being part of it, by participating in the events and anything like that? Sorry for the hard question.
No, you're sorry. I think, you gain a lot of unique perspective. What I'm most impressed about here is just the quality and cut of people that come, there's so many different people that pivot from careers or just have like stellar professional lives before they come here. You gain a lot of networking experience and managerial insight of how to really collect all of that talent and point it towards like a greater good or a common good.
Awesome. Okay. Thank you, guys. Okay. For the next one, then, we're going to talk a little bit about the academic clubs. So some examples are the Business Information Management Association, the Consulting Club, the Entrepreneurship Society, the Finance Association, the Graduate Supply Chain Management Association, the Healthcare Club, and Strategic Marketing Association. So one thing that I have seen, at least, is, for example, you guys sometimes inside these clubs invite some speakers, right, for the events. So have you had any experience in this type of events? And can you describe a little bit more about what you do in these academic clubs and what type of events you hold for that?
I'll talk about the BIMA Club. BIMA Club is the Business Analytics and Information Management Association. So this aligns with BA and IM concentrations that we have here at WP Carey. This club generally does a lot of speaker events, speakers who are working in business analyst roles, who are doing analytics at top level companies. They come and give talks about what they do in their day-to-day life and what are the skills they expect from potential students who come out of school. This club prepares students so that they can succeed in their business management associate career. And they also conduct R classes and Python classes where they train students to learn more on R programming and Python programming so that students also get the hard coding skills when they get into their job.
Okay, that's awesome. So what are the clubs, for example, you are in the supply chain one, right, Jessica?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Okay, I am. They have a really great speaker series. That's how I met Dan Colton through Intel. And that really sparked a conversation about removing like bonded labor through your procurement and just talking about what kind of like market mechanisms you can use in like real life application. It's just an example of some knowledge that you can't really get from a textbook, something that you won't even get a chance to talk about in like career fairs. So it's just really useful information that not only helps you in your professional life, but also if you're preparing for like a case competition or a special project, they just open a lot of doors for you joining these clubs.
Awesome. Does anyone want to speak about any other different club? Like, you are also in the Strategic Marketing Association, right?
Yeah, I am part of Strategic Marketing and Product Management Club as well. So yeah. Strategic Marketing Club helps all those that are in the marketing concentration that want to explore a career in marketing after their MBA program. It's brand management, product management, brand marketing, digital marketing. This association bridges gap between the curriculum and the real life experience they need. They conduct a lot of events throughout the school, starting from an event called Trained in Marketing. This Trained in Marketing is a great event that gives all the frameworks that helps students develop the frameworks that are used in marketing interviews, marketing jobs, everywhere. I would say that is one of the best event organized by our clubs at WP Carey. And moving forward, they conduct a lot of speaker events again, and they conduct action.
Sorry, I'm gonna mute. Someone is with the audio open. Okay, perfect.
They also conduct marketing in action series where live projects are taken into place, and they talk about that. This is related to marketing association, Strategic Marketing Association. And Dave and I co-lead Product Management Association. This is to help students who are interested in product management career. And we are providing resources. We are providing case preparation and the actual jobs that they can encounter. So we are providing the resources for the students so that they can excel in their career.
Oh, that's awesome.
Yeah, we're really discussing a lot of great clubs that we have here. So if anybody that's listening in would like to ask any questions about specific clubs, please feel free to use the chat. We're more than happy to kind of address your questions when we get a break in the conversation. But just feel as if this is a chance for you guys to get a lot more insight on your own personal interests and what we have to offer here at WP Carey.
Awesome. Yeah, that's great. Can anyone, I'm sorry if this is a hard question, but can anyone describe to me the difference of the academic clubs and the next type that is the professional clubs?
I can try to take that one.
Sorry.
No, you're fine. Because I think they do a lot of times work together in a lot of their events. Some of the professional clubs, they won't look at like the nuances of specific subject material like the academic clubs will. So for example, I am part of the Women's Leadership Association. So some of the things that we do is we'll work together with the academic clubs to provide resources and shared learning experiences for our events. So for example, most recently we did an event with the Strategic Marketing Club where the speaker focused on gender marketing. So that was a big event for us because we were able to bring in two different perspectives, both the professional and the academic side of things. So at the end of the event, our goal was kind of to have that be something that was on the forefront of people's minds. So in a lot of our clubs, we see like the professional clubs working together with the academic ones to put on events. And I think that's really cool because you're able to then bring two different perspectives to an event. And it's sometimes things where you don't necessarily think they'll go hand in hand, but then the event gets put on and it ends up being really great. So that's something that's really fun. And I think it allows the professional clubs to have a level of representation that they might not necessarily always get within an industry. Specifically for women's leadership, that's one of our goals is we're always trying to provide that representation in different industries that tend to be male dominated. So getting that opportunity, I think, is a really great experience to help our students become like better and more effective leaders.
Great, thank you. So some of the examples then of professional, actually the MBA Association is kind of considered also one of the professional clubs. We also have the Net Impact, the Volunteer Council, and then the Women's Leadership Association that Nishani just mentioned. Can you speak a little bit about the Net Impact, Jessica?
Yeah, certainly. It's focused on sustainability, and so that includes not only like environment, but social and governance too. This was a great blessing for me personally to go in there because they're also affiliated with like Green Biz and the Sustainability Forum and a lot of these huge conferences that really put you in line and in sight of ethical businesses that take care of their people and the communities they source from. So, for example, the Sustainability Forum was a couple weeks ago, and because of Net Impact and because of the people I'd become familiar with, they pulled me in to facilitate a conversation with people that are like 20, 30 years my senior that are like heads of recycling and waste management. And it was really humbling, but also really exciting that you can be placed in such like a well-grounded network to open these doors for you.
Awesome. Okay. So I think this is great. I think it, I mean, for me, seeing this from outside, the opportunity of having this powerful conversations that you guys have inside the clubs and, you know, organizations, and also having these visits from alumni or different professionals that come to visit for focus in each club, I think that's a great way of gaining a lot of experience and actually making that connection from academic to professional. So we always try to make everyone really participating in as many clubs as you guys can, because I know that you guys' schedule is also really busy. But one thing also, for the next type of clubs, you also have to have fun. So thinking of that, so there are some special interest clubs. So I'm gonna name some of them. Golf club, improv club, Spanish club, standout club, standout MBA, and then the Toast Devils and the Wine Society. Can you guys talk about these clubs or what type of events you have? And if you do attend, if you have fun, how is it?
So I can talk about this. So a lot of the special interest clubs, like Jonna said, like they're aimed at having a good time and making sure that you're able to build that community with your classmates. A lot of the other like academic and professional clubs will also put on events with the special interest clubs. So you're still getting a lot of like different experiences from this. I'm part of the Wine Society. So most recently we had an event that was called Reading Between the Wines, where we discussed an article that focused on gender marketing to women. And we talked about that over a glass or two of wine. So it's really fun, but I think the biggest thing is being able to connect with your classmates. And our clubs aren't just open to only MBA students. We are able to get students from the MSBA programs and the ProFlex MBA program. So you're not just getting to know your own classmates, but you're opening up your network and your friendships and relationships to some of the people in the other programs, so you get to know them as well. So I think that's one of the most fun things, is getting to know people outside of your program, and being able to kind of share these experiences with them.
Yeah, I almost feel that some of these, exactly the connection that you made, even though you're drinking wine, you're actually connecting with the marketing, and you're actually connecting to something that is still useful for your academics and professional career. If you think, for example, of the Toast Devils, I think that that's amazing, right? So it's like you actually learning how to speak in public or things like that. Did any of you guys participate in the Toast or improv or any other different club for fun?
Yeah, I can talk about Toast Devils. So my roommate leads the Toast Devils club as well. So Toast Devils is the Toastmaster version in WP Carry. As business professionals, we will be presenting a lot. In our career, we'll be making a lot of presentations to different people, and it's understandable that everyone has that anxiety, has that nervousness when you get into public and have to deliver a great presentation or a very important presentation, maybe in front of 100 people or even 1,000 people over our career. And this club helps us to overcome that fear and come up with develop skills and practice them in front of public, in front of everyone, in front of new audience, and help alleviate the nervousness and anxiety. I was also nervous earlier, like unable to talk in front of a large number of people. This club helped me improve a bit on that.
That's awesome. Yeah.
And I can talk to the golf club. So, you know, the golf club is focused on doing a variety of things as it relates to golf. So, you know, there are events such as helping to facilitate getting tee times on a course like where the Phoenix Open just happened. There's also things like where, so for those that are familiar with golf, one of the main manufacturers is Ping, and Ping is actually headquartered here in Phoenix. So we've done a tour of the Ping facility, actually watching clubs being made, which is pretty cool. But then another thing and platform that the club does is it opens the game up to golf to everyone that's interested in it, regardless of your skill level. So there are a few golf classes, Golf 101 and 102. They're not academic classes, but it's just what the golf club calls them. And depending on your skill, you can enroll in these classes, and then you'll actually work with LPGA professional and helping to give lessons. And Ashani has actually been going through those.
Yeah, and they're super fun because, like Dave said, like it really helps you get confident about something that not really when anyone knows about. And then when you kind of get into it, you so the golf club, they put on these lessons with the Women's Leadership Association. So we talk about how a lot of times women miss out on the opportunities in the workplace because they don't know how to golf or don't know how to talk about golf and things like that. So I went through both levels of those golf lessons, and like I'm still not great, but that's not the point. It's fun to be able to kind of like just hang out and then learn a new skill with some people. And it's not, you know, different types of people from different walks of life come together. So, you know, whatever their athletic background was, it doesn't really matter anymore because we're all learning this new skill. So that's been super fun. And we were able to kind of keep it going. So even when we're done with, you know, both those levels of lessons, we still get together like once a month and we'll go to the driving range or go play golf on a course or something like that.
That's great. And I think a little connected to what you said, I think I learned once that because you guys have the executive connections program that connects you with the mentor for the whole duration of the program. And then when they're trying to match you with the mentor, they make questions about not only your interests in terms of academic and professional interests, but also if you like to golf, whatever else that you like to do. And that if you like golfing, for example, they connect you with a mentor that also likes to do that. You can do your meetings like that. So I think these little details of trying to connect you with a mentor and then okay, I'm not great at golfing either, but now you're making me want to learn that as well, because I think that's a great skill. So it does take you out of your comfort zone. And I think, again, you can use that for professional meetings as well and connect with more people. So I think that's a great point. Anything else about special interest clubs? No? Okay. So to talk a little bit about the campus culture and then the campus culture, and I'm actually wanted to toss to Siva a little, because I think for you being an international student, I wanted to know a little bit before about your perspective of how it was to come to the US here, if you had been before to Arizona, before actually joining the program, and how it was to adapt, and what do you think about the culture here at WPCary?
One word is awesome. Like, when I came here, I was completely mind-blocked that how I will survive here, what I will do here, how will I make friends. I don't have any friends here. This is my first visit here. So how will I make friends? Like, will I be able to survive, or like, will I be able to succeed in my career, in my subjects? But first, even we had our induction in the first week, made few friends over that. And then we had our camp carry. So it's a 3-day event where all the MBA students, we get to vacation place and then have fun time over there for around 3 days. That's where I made a lot of friends, and it's more of collaborative culture over here, and making friends is really easy here. And it's more of people coming and talking to me. I'm kind of an introvert, so a lot of people came and to me and made a lot of good friends along 1.5 years here.
That's awesome. So one thing that I wanted to know as well, I think the campus culture here, I think it's one great thing that I see is some of the events like tailgating, for example, is actually even open to family as well. Have you seen this around, and have you brought your family as well? So I wanted to see what type of events you have attended here, and how do you feel about this environment if for someone that would like to bring their family as well, to join them here in Arizona?
So I have kids. I have three kids, and my youngest is 4, Donovan, and he wasn't sure about letting me go to school. And so I brought him over, and Christine and John, they went out of their way to meet him and talk with him, and then we gave him like a tour, and then he felt like it was okay to let me go, and we went to Starbucks. So and there's been times even with reviews late at night that I brought my kids, and I just have really great classmates. Like, we all take turns like making paper fortune tellers, and there's just, people are very supportive and open for families and children too. That was something I was really nervous about, because there isn't as many people with children. I think I have the oldest children here. But with tailgating and just genuinely kind people, they've been very welcoming.
So is there anything else, for example, do you have interaction with students from other colleges as well? In what is the instance that you do have? So we know of programs that we have, for example, the learning labs or things like that, where you can interact with students from other colleges. But do you see around as well? Is there anything specific that you actually get to interact with other colleges and other ASU students?
Yeah, so I can talk about our learning lab experience and being able to talk and kind of collaborate with other students from different colleges. In our specific learning lab, we were looking at sustainability measurements. So we were partnered with a girl who was in the School of Sustainability and Sustainable Engineering. So it's really interesting to see kind of the different personalities across different colleges and different skill set that each college is able to bring to the table. Sometimes I think we think that we know everything, but we don't. So being able to have another perspective is great, but also understanding that we, like, both parties have something to teach the other party. So I think that was one of the biggest takeaways for my learning lab experience, was that everyone has something to learn. So you're not always going to be the expert in everything, but, even across colleges, I think the culture is quite similar. Everyone's super welcoming and friendly and willing to learn and wanting to teach and things like that. So being able to make those friendships and those connections, over a semester long class is also pretty incredible.
Awesome.
So I kind of briefly mentioned that I had a special project. It's an exhibit called Chainbreakers. It's about how to identify modern slavery and how to halt it. And it's campus-wide. So we have a lot of like cross collaboration, especially with the fine arts, because we're doing like a pilot exhibit that's more academic. So we have more people from like school sustainability and law and the humanities. But next year when it's the full-blown exhibit, we'll have the actual art pieces. So we've been able to work with people from Herberger Institute and some of the local museums around too. So I'm just, W.P. Carey has a great reputation and they just really open their network across the valley. So even not only on the colleges, but like community-wide too, it has a really great reputation.
Yeah, I think it's great. And that's why I wanted to highlight a little, because you will have a lot of experience inside W.P. Carey, but you do have interaction with ASU as overall and it's open to you. So for example, the ISSC, that it's the International Students and Scholars Center, they're always doing events as well for international students and families and whoever can come. So I think you will see a lot of that available to you. And again, you have to juggle a little with the time that you have available and everything that you want to do at the same time. But I think there's always some amazing opportunities to participate in the culture inside ASU. So right now I'm going to mute the presentation for a little bit. We're going to read through the questions that we have, and then I'm going to be back in a couple minutes just to answer the questions with everyone.
All right, wonderful. So we've already gotten a few questions thrown at us. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to address the one from Imani. Imani's asking, if I take business analytics along with MBA courses, will it be eligible for STEM? I can tell you that yes, very briefly, business analytics and information systems management is expected to be STEM designated for fall 2020. As long as you take one of those areas of emphasis, you will be eligible for the 36 months of OPT. I know that's a very big question, very big consideration. But I think we have a couple of other questions here more geared towards clubs and culture around ASU, which we're going to address right now.
Yeah, so every time that you have these other questions, they're more towards the curriculum or the application process. Since it's not the theme of the webinar today, just let us know after. You can email Steven and I, and we'll be happy to support you. So one of the questions that we received here directly to us, I wanted to know from you guys, what are like the resources or funding that Precari provides to you when you're doing your club? So how does that work? Can anyone explain to me?
I can take this question. So it's been around 6 to 8 months since Dave and I started the product management. So the experience is very fresh to talk about that. It's very easy to start a club. When we were discussing about starting our club, we were very apprehensive how we can start one, what is the red tape process over here, whether we will be able to get it live on time, and whether we will be able to support with funding, everything. But everyone, right from MBAA to GPSA to our faculty advisor, even till dean, everyone was very receptive and supportive of our of us starting the club in order to help the students. So I would say it's an easy process. Getting funding, we can get from MBAA, we can get from career services, and we can get from university level GPSA to fund all our events. So this should be very reasonable and should have more impact on all the students that are interested here. So if that's the case, getting a funding is easy, and starting a club and running a club is easy.
Awesome. Okay, so for the next question, they're asking us, since you mentioned about the Executive Connections program, how does the mentorship process work? Can anyone answer for us?
Sure, yeah, I can. They have a huge pool of like C-suite individuals that have immense experience in lots of different fields, and they assign you one mentor, but it's open to everybody. You can meet with other mentors as well. For example, my mentor is Holly Barrett, and she was the vice president of finance at Intel. She retired and decided it was boring, so she went back to work, and she's a VP of finance for Banner Health, and is a huge change agent there. And it's really great just to have somebody on your side who truly cares about your career and can answer any question. She's been really direct and not having anything off the table. So whether it's like family dynamics in the workforce, or knowing which companies from her point and specific people to network with, it can't really compare with anything else that I've seen in other programs, having that direct access to people who truly are mentors in every word of the sense. So that's huge.
Yeah, I can add to that. So elaborate a little bit more from what Jessica was saying. So up front, what we do is you provide a lot of platforms and sessions where we get to interact with all the different executive mentors and see, you know, what the right fit is, because the whole goal is that it's a relationship which continues to grow, and that is a two-way street, and that both sides are getting something out of it. So that match is important. And then going off of more of what Jessica was saying, I actually just met with my executive mentor yesterday morning. And, you know, I love it in the sense she's a CEO for a healthcare system out here. And, you know, outside of some of the advice she can give me, you just really appreciate it, because they can be your accountability partner. So, you know, there are a lot of things that I share with her, and I say, I want you to hold me accountable to this. And because these executives have the sort of position that they're in, they know how to properly go about holding you accountable without kind of pushing you in an uncomfortable way. So, you know, for me, it's been very amazing experience.
And another thing that Jessica touched on is that there's like a large pool of mentors. So oftentimes they'll have events where all the mentors will be at this event. And if there's something specific you want to talk to a different mentor about, or if there's a mentor that has a specific background that you're interested in, you're totally able to go meet with that mentor and just talk to them and ask them questions. And, you know, you might even walk out with a second informal mentor from that. But I think it's really cool that we have access to so many people with like a variety, you know, of backgrounds, ranging from like physicians to CEOs to like, you know, I think someone's running for like their state, not Congress, but like their city council or something like that. So it's nice to have people with different experiences, you know, that you don't think will relate to you, but in the end, usually sometimes do.
Yeah, it's awesome. Okay, let me just check again to see if we have any question left, and I'll be right back. One more. Okay, so one last question that we had here. So I saw in the website that you have what is called Net Investor. Can you explain to me what this is? Is this another club?
So the Net Investors program is something that our director came up with. And it's sort of when people go out of their way to build community and really they encompass that business personal motto of W.P. Carey. So it's when they go out of their way to really do something for the community that gives back and supports fellow students. So for example, some of our past winner or, you know, awardees of the Net Impact Award, they are people who have like put on study sessions or tutoring sessions for statistics and finance. And, you know, students have had a really positive interaction with that, and you know, they really went out of their way to do something they didn't have to do for the greater good of the community. We are fortunate to have two of those award winners here in the room with us today. So you know, they both went out of their way to do things you know, for the student organizations and really kind of put themselves out there to create an experience that would be, you know, really positive for their fellow students. So that's something that's pretty unique to our program. We're really just wanting to recognize the people who give back positively to our community.
Yeah, that's awesome. Congrats, guys. So Jessica and Siva won the awards. Well done. Okay, so this is it for today. We're going to wrap up. We are recording this, so we will send a link after as well. So if you have any little trouble listening to some part of the webinar, know that we usually need around 48 hours to actually be able to send you this link, okay? But yeah, let's stay in touch. If you have any questions about the program or the admissions process, we'll be happy to support you. Sorry, I'm seeing one last question here. Okay, can anyone answer to this question? So does W.P. Carey MBA Club run activities, competitions, discussion with other universities or business school?
I can talk of one. GCSMA, the supply chain association here, they run a competition along with Chevron. Chevron sponsors the event every year. There is a Chevron case competition where winners from W.P. Carey compete with winners from Penn State, and I think winners from one more business school, supply chain focus school. And if I remember correctly, for the last 2 years or 3 years, we are the winners in that competition as well.
Yeah, that's a great point. A lot of our collaborations with other schools will come through the form of case competition. So I know we do one at, we usually go to one at Michigan State. You know, there's a lot of different case competitions that we host as well. I know we did one a few years ago with Televerde, which is a local a business here, which is really interesting, and they kind of focus more on the corporate social responsibility area of things. So yes, we do, to answer your question, we do do a lot of things with other schools in the form of competitions and case competitions. So that's definitely an opportunity that a lot of people take advantage of.
Yeah, I've been to a case competition at Harvard for marketing. I know that there have also been classmates of ours that have done case competitions, which are a little unique in that half of your score is based on your actual case, and the other half is your ability to get down a mountain as fast as possible. So there are a lot of different case competitions out there, and a lot of these are open to really any MBA program, and you know, WP Carey is very willing to go out of their way to help with funding and resources to make you successful.
Yeah, awesome. Thank you so much for this last question, Tanu Bayan. I'm not so sure if I'm saying that correctly. Well done. So I'm glad that we're able to answer that. You're welcome. Okay, so we're gonna wrap up. Again, this will be recorded. If you have any questions about the program or the admissions process, please contact Joanna or Steven, and our contacts are in there. We'll be happy to support you. Have a great rest of your day. Thank you for coming. Bye-bye.